Friends, I welcome you all in the online session of science. Today we are going to revise the chapter number 1, that is nutrition in plants. First, let us talk about what is nutrition. It is the process by which organisms obtain nutrients from the food and use them for their growth, development and maintenance of the body. Basically, there are two modes of nutrition. That is number 1, autotrophic, nutrition, and number 2, heterotrophic nutrition. In the heterotrophic category, we are having different modes of nutrition that are number 1, parasitic, number 2, saprophytic, number 3, symbiotic, and number 4, insectivorous. Now, we will discuss these type of nutrition one by one. So, first of all, we will discuss autotrophic mode of nutrition. In this type of nutrition, plants, or we can say green plants, make their food with the help of carbon dioxide and water. Autotrophs perform the reaction, that is photosynthesis. So, we will discuss the reaction here, okay? So, I will write here photosynthesis. And the reaction is carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll gives oxygen plus glucose, that is food of the plant, plus energy. So, some organisms cannot prepare their food. They mainly depend on other plants and animals for their food. Such organisms are called heterotrophs, and the nutrition is called heterotrophic nutrition. In this, we will understand all the four types of nutrition one by one. So, first one is parasitic mode of nutrition. In this, organisms live on or inside the body of other organisms to drive their food. इस केस में क्या होता है? ये जो parasites होते हैं, वो दूसरे organisms की body के अंदर या ऊपर रहके वहाँ से food लेते हैं। इसका best example है कसकुट्टा, जिसे बोलते हैं अमरबेल। ये क्या करती है? बड़े पेड़ों के ऊपर hang करती है और वहाँ से अपना nutrition लेती है। Second one is saprophytic nutrition. That means saprotrophs. Organisms that drive their nutrition from dead and rotten organisms are called saprotrophs, and the nutrition is called saprophytic nutrition. For example, in the rainy season, you have seen your shoes, leather shoes or belts, you have seen the white powder-like substance. This is the fungal growth, that is saprophytes. Now, third mode of nutrition is symbiotic. Means, in this category, organisms live together, different organisms live together, and they are mutually benefited. For example, lichens. Lichens is the best example, we can say, because it is the association between algae and fungus. Our last mode of nutrition is insectivorous nutrition. Have you ever heard about meat-eating animals? Yes, the answer is yes, because some plants eat other small insects or animals, so they are called carnivorous plants, or we can say insectivorous plants. For example, Venus flytrap and pitcher plant. Our last topic in this chapter is replenishing the nutrients in the soil. You know, plant requires various types of nutrition, and these nutritions are nitrogen, phosphorus, calcium, magnesium and potassium. These nutrients are provided by the plant from the soil. Slowly, these nutrients in the soil keep on decreasing, so we have to add. How we can add? We can add manure or fertilizers in the soil to enrich the fertility of the soil. Most of the plant requires the nitrogen for making the protein. So from where this nitrogen comes? Nitrogen comes from the atmosphere, but the roots of the plants cannot absorb it directly. So there is a bacteria called rhizobium bacteria in the soil. What they did? They just, we can say, fixed the nitrogen and converted it into soluble form so that easily it is absorbed by the roots of the plant. So, this is the complete revision of the chapter. I hope you all have enjoyed. Thank you and keep revising.